when every method of persuasion in 13 years of preaching had failed, the Prophet took to the sword. The sword removed evil, mischief, the impurities of the hearts, the evilness and the filth of the soul, and also cured the people of the time of their arrogance. Dr. Wilfred Cantwell Smith states, Muhammad preached Islam with a sword in one hand and the Quran in the other. However, the critics are blind in this matter. They cannot see that the sword wielded by Prophet Muhammad was the sword of mercy, compassion, friendship, forgiveness, the sword that conquers enemies and purifies the hearts. His sword was more sharper than the sword of iron or steel. This is why tonight's episode is one of the most controversial topics to be debated and discussed over multimedia. Tonight's episode is dedicated to clear up the misconceptions regarding the methods used by Islam in spreading the religion of Islam in light of the Quran. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to the 7th episode of Life from Karbala Ramadan series with me, your host Ahmed Ali. Tonight's episode, as I mentioned, is very controversial. This is why my esteemed guest, Sayyid Hussein Al-Qazwini, has joined us once again in tonight's episode to clear up these misconceptions. Welcome back, Hayu Sayyidina.
Ahla wa marhaba.
Allah khalikum, inshaAllah. Yesterday, something very tragic happened in the U.S., especially in Orlando. Tonight's episode is somewhat related to what happened yesterday. Preaching the religion of Islam has various methods, and it's unfortunate to see that, you know, the people that take the religion of Islam extreme to the next level, and they just cherry pick whatever they want and they apply it. But what is the importance of da'wah, preaching, and how should we as Muslim preach Islam to others? I mean, take for example the shooting that happened yesterday in Orlando, that was motivated by homosexuals deserve death penalty. I mean, it's clear that da'wah has major effects. Should we use aggression in this manner? It's a sinful act, that's, of course it is. But should we use aggression in such matters?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين. We live at very critical times.
Mm-hmm.
The spotlight is completely on Islam today, especially since a group of extremists who have misunderstood Islam.
Mm-hmm.
And consequently, they are misrepresenting Islam,
yes,
through their actions. For them, da'wah to Islam comes by aggression.
Yes.
Inviting people to Islam and introducing them to the laws of Allah comes through aggression,
mm-hmm,
and violence, through hatred,
mm-hmm,
through barbarism. These people, we have nothing in common with them. The ISIS mentality, they're far from the Quran.
Are they?
Very far from the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
They're far from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi,
mm-hmm,
the traditions of Rasulullah, and they have not understood how Islam is supposed to be implemented today.
Mm-hmm.
The problem with many preachers and many speakers and many scholars today is the way they're trying to get their point across.
Mm-hmm.
They have a passion for Islam.
Yes.
Some people, their passion stems from ignorance.
Mm-hmm.
Others, they stem from knowledge. But how do they get their point across to the other side? The other side could be a non-Muslim.
Mm-hmm.
It could be an American, a European, a Westerner that has no idea of Islam, and they're, mm-hmm, trying to teach them and educate them about Islam. Or it could be another Muslim that disagrees with them.
Yes.
That, you know, that relates to another school of thought.
Mm-hmm. Sectarianism.
Sectarianism, to another ideology.
Yes.
They're trying to teach them their version of Islam, But it's a matter of how. How are you getting your point across?
Yeah.
Is it through aggression, through violence, through name calling, through disrespect? Is it everything that you say, it must be said? Everything that's written literally in the Quran should be said and taken for face value, or should it be analyzed? Should, you know, time and place has a role mm-hmm. in certain laws. Mm-hmm. This all plays a major role in the invitation of Islam. Mm-hmm. That is why it's mm-hmm. a critical job. It's not for everyone to come and say, you know what, this is Islam, I'd like to call. It's a very detailed, specific job. It's very intricate, it's very dangerous, it's very mm-hmm. sensitive. You have to be politically correct mm-hmm. in how to convey the message to others without offending your own faith, mm-hmm. without giving a bad image of your own faith. Mm-hmm. This is all part of the manners of da'wah in mm-hmm. Islam. Mm-hmm.
You just said that not everything within the Quran should be said. Is that, you know, after understanding? I mean, isn't the Quran clear?
No, you see, not that everything in the Quran should not be said, as in we should hide certain things, no. But there are some things in the Quran that should be understood within a context. Mm-hmm. That should be understood within a context. Yesterday,
yes,
I heard a speaker, and this is in the United States of America. Mm-hmm. You know, and this is what I'd like to emphasize on.
Yes.
Not the idiot who went on a shooting rampage and who killed 50 or 49 or I don't know how many people. No. Mm-hmm. That person, I have nothing in common with him to discuss. He has no reason, no rational sort of thinking. He has no logic. So
isn't he entitled as a Muslim?
He's a Muslim by name. Mm-hmm. He's a Muslim by name, but not by intellect. That's my discussion is not with him because I have nothing in common with him. My discussion is with those that are not violent physically, mm-hmm. but they're violent intellectually in their means of da'wah. Mm-hmm. You see them on TV, on channels, all over the media, on YouTube. Their style of preaching, their style of condemning, this is a mushrik, this is a kafir, this person deserves execution, this person deserves death, this person deserves to be killed.
Who are they?
This sort of aggression, not just with non-Muslims, mm-hmm. but even with Muslims themselves.
Yes.
This person is an innovator. This person is a mushrik. This is bid'ah. This is kufr. This is sometimes within the same school of thought.
Yes.
In the same school of thought, we have takfiris in the same school of thought. Mm-hmm. This person's a munharif. This person's dhal, a deviant. This person has strayed away. This person's not a follower of Ahlul Bayt. My issues with these kind of people, that we have something in common with them. They're preachers. And for me, this sort of person who has the freedom to speak and has a platform and comes on TV or on social media and is watched by millions, this person can do damage to Islam and Muslims more than the one that goes and terrorizes.
Really?
More than the one that goes and terrorizes. Because that person is an idiot. Mm-hmm. He goes and he kills. It's very bad. But he doesn't claim to be a spokesman for Islam. Those who come and speak, they're claiming to be spokesmen.
But that person,
right now, mm-hmm. my job is very dangerous. Mm-hmm. Because right now, I'm claiming to be a spokesman for Islam.
But he
so if I make a mistake, mm-hmm. it will be reflected on Islam. Mm-hmm.
He claims to be a representative of Islam.
True. True. That is correct. However, his way of thinking is so ill, it's so irrational mm-hmm. that it doesn't need a lot of proof and a lot of convincing to come and say, this shouldn't be done.
Yeah.
This shouldn't be done. My issue, my fight is with my colleagues from my religion, my school of thought, preachers mm-hmm. and religious scholars like myself who have a platform and they speak, but they're not using the etiquettes of da'wah mentioned in the Quran.
Yeah.
The ethics and manners of da'wah that Islam, the Quran specifically, has given us, mm-hmm. the tools that the Quran has given us, they're not being used. These people are more harmful than many others.
Definitely.
And we have narrations regarding this, that a scholar has a great value in Islam. His worship is equivalent to the worship of 1,000 worshippers. But at the same time, his danger is worse than the danger of 1,000 soldiers.
He has a heavy burden upon his shoulders.
1,000 soldiers cannot do a harm as much as one scholar.
Yeah.
Or a person who claims to be a scholar.
Definitely, because he destructs within.
Yes. So my issue is, how are you promoting Islam?
Mm-hmm.
How are you... Today, we live in a critical age.
We do.
Today, I was watching CNN. I was listening to Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton is now... She's most likely going to be the Democratic presidential nominee.
Mm-hmm.
For the elections, and there's a big chance that she will be elected as president. Today I was hearing her on CNN saying that I do not have a problem with using the word radical Islam.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Radical Islam. I'll use the word radical Islam. This is dangerous.
Very dangerous.
This is very dangerous. What are we doing to combat that? Are we making it worse? Are we giving her content? Are we, you know, encouraging her by our actions
definitely.
And by our sayings? Or should we combat that idea of radical Islam by another approach,
mm-hmm.
a peaceful approach,
yes.
of showing the gems and the jewels of Islam? We're living at a very difficult time.
We are.
And the job and the responsibility is on the shoulders of the scholars and the preachers. How are you representing Islam? How are you performing da'wah? How are you inviting people? What face of Islam are you giving? This is the issue.
I mean, as you mentioned, radical Islam, you know, it stems from the same ideology that this person is actually, you know, what motivates this person. If someone actually goes into, you know, whatever he might think that it is, going in there and shooting someone, you know, unnecessarily and unwittingly, you know what I mean? Just going in there shooting people, that doesn't make any sense. It doesn't prove anything that Islam is what? Islam wants to kill these individuals, but yet in the Quran we do see that whoever kills one person is like he killed all of humanity. So we do see that. But in chapter 16, verse 125, Allah states, invite in the way of your Lord with wisdom and good advice and argue, debate with them in a way that is best. Indeed, your Lord is the most knowing of those who has strayed from his way, and he knows the people who have rightly guided. But yet, we do see in the Quran and the traditions that it also says, you know, chase them under every rock.
I could safely say that inspired against Rasulullah. So there were three. They all had a specific context. حسنة with good advice. Speak to the people's mind. And things that don't make sense. Of education speak to him according to his level of intellect, not above. But yes. To understand deep. Would understand how to prove God's existence. Yes. This is part of wisdom. Scholars in the West. In the Bible that says or taken out of context.
Definitely. same person who actually went and killed the homosexuals.
Results.
About to warm up.